All right. Hello, everyone. Live with Train Some World 2 today. And, let's see what kind of shenanigans we can get into. Happy Saturday. Excuse me. I don't know what route I want to do. Somerset. I haven't been on this route in quite some time. We can do a scenario. Ah, perfect. Go to the beach. To cope with increased demand, the resident class 9 has been called upon to operate extra services. Alright, this will take about 75 minutes, it looks like. That's quite a long time, but we shall start it. Until we run a red signal and end the scenario, because that's likely to happen. Double discounts. That's the first time I've seen that on appear on the game. It actually showed the discounts. Welcome to Bishop's Linyard. Let's get this train into service. Okay. Let's go in to the cab. And we will sit in the driver's seat. Set the main light switch to on. This is the main light switch. Oh, it's probably that. Marker lights. It's the main light switch. Climb down and switch the marker lights on. Okay. There's one. There's two. If I can reach these ones or not. Oh, there we go. There's three, and sort of that last one over there. Hopefully another train doesn't come through here. We're trying to get the flight on. There we go. We good. Alright, so we can go ahead and unlock the doors. On the right side. Okay. There we go. Luncheons will not affect your throat. New cough cure. Coughs and colds. Insist upon having table mustard. What else we got here? Robinson's Golden Shred Marmalade. Use pure concentrated cocoa. Coffin cure. Insist upon having shredded sweet. Not shredded wheat. Shredded sweet. Sold in cardboard boxes. Oh, nice. Poster of West Somerset. Very nice. Very nice. I like it. Oh, hello, sir. Excuse me, sir. Welcome to the West Somerset Railway. Waiting room. Shop and cafe. All right. So we'll be going in just a few moments here. Just gonna have a quick look at the carriage. It's definitely the carriages from way back when. All in great detail. Very nice. All right, looks like we are ready to go. So we're gonna go ahead and climb back up here. Have a little sit down. We will lock the doors. There we go. All right, set the reversers, your forward. Set the brakes to release. Those are all release. Sound the horn and apply some throttle. There we go. We are rolling. Nice. So we should have some nice views along the way. Obviously, this is not a high-speed route, so it's kind of a sit back and enjoy the ride. Take in all the sights and sounds. We're on our way to Crew Comedy Heathfield. solar panels out there. I haven't seen any signal displays so far. That was a signal right there. Okay, so now it's showing up on the signal. Miles. We got a yellow signal. And a 20 mile an hour zone. Right where our stop will be at. Some nice houses down there. cool little village we got here. So this line was opened in 1862, according to Wikipedia. It wasn't until 1874 when it opened up the Minehead station. And this line would run until 1973, and then it would fortunately be closed. Spans 22.75 miles of track. I guess there's 11 stations along this route, apparently. Some cows. Some cows out there. It's definitely the countryside. There's a lot of open areas around here. Gonna be approaching Crocombe. That's how you say that.
We can call it Hethfield.
Stopping there, we'll load on some passengers, hopefully. And then we can depart to the next station. To test out these brakes here, see how good they are on this old train. I don't want to coast just yet because it will probably slow us right down. See, I already lowered the throttle a little bit, and it's already slowing us down quite a bit. So we might not even need the brakes here, to be honest. I mean, like a little bit. So we need to stop right up here. Let's see if we can do it. Make sure we don't go past the signal right here. Alright, throttle's off. Brakes on the out. I think we're gonna pass it. Yep. Yep, we did it anyways, of course. Yep, that sounds about right. okay, moving on. We didn't attempt at that and failed. Let's do a timetable then with the Class 47 GRN. Looks like it's got another livery too, interesting. Class 47 for BLU. Oh, this one's part of the Northern TransPenn. I see. Interesting. We can run that on here. Very interesting. But we're going to use the classic one here. And we will do empty stock move to Minehead. Let's do that. Do be used later in the day. All right. Alright, move locomotive from the engine shed to mine head for use later in the day. Okay. Alright, let's get this set up. Turn the master key on. We will turn on. Headlight switch. There we go. That's what I was looking for. And do we have the dash one too? I think it's over here somewhere. Deathlight. There we go. Okay. Put our reverser into forward. Use the driver brake to overcharge, and we'll let that charge up. Just like that. And go ahead and give it some power. I'm just gonna stop just ahead here. We'll be backing up onto the other track here. And then that'll switch us to the main track. Use the brake. There we go. I think we were supposed to switch the track there, but the game didn't tell us that. So we're not going into the shed there. Yeah. It was supposed to tell us to switch track, but it did not. So, let me go forward here a bit. Oh. Still going in reverse. Nope. Okay, let's get out of reverse. Forward. Release. So it's going to pull up to about the track switch right there. It's going to go past the track switch, and we'll get out and change it. All right, right there should be good. All right, let's get out. A little bucket here. Fire bucket. Nice, we filled it. And now we will move the junction lever. Let's see if that's the right way. I think it is. I think it's the only other option you can do, so should be right now. Let's find out. Yep, there we go. Okay, now entering the main track. And we should be good. Feel like we should be down at the other end of the train so we can see what's going on. Instead of going to the top camera here. Might actually have to switch the control, the camera settings here. Is it? Oh, right, we gotta do it this other way here. This way. Controls. Classic. All right. External cameras and the rear camera? Yes. There we go. Now it will stay up there. We got 7.5 miles to the Minehead up loop. Zone. all the trees. Oh, brake selector. New brake passenger. Battery isolation open. Parking brake released. Good. AWS cab changeover lever. Turn that on. What's that? Isolation switch isolated. Turn that on. Let's see what that does. Oh, the cab light. Okay. We're gonna slow it up a little bit. Oh, that's not what I wanted. The rear camera. There we go. That's what I wanted. I wonder if I can switch. Let's stop here for a second. If we can switch ends. Wonder if that is possible. Alright, so we need to. Control shut down. Off. Turn that off. We will. That's gonna be turned off. Yes. Now we can turn that off. All right. So let's switch ends here. Let's actually put on that, and we'll put on the tail lights, and we'll switch to the other end of the cab. Yes. Alright, yeah, this is much better. Now I can actually see from in the cab here and not have to look back each time. Fix that and turn that back on. We are rolling. Turn that on. That on. Tail light source. We'll leave that off. We should be good. Oh, I forgot to turn off the other switches on the other end. That's all right. It's fine. Just leave those. This is a little bit better. Must be the beach down there to our right, looks like. I can't see now because of the buildings, but it's like over there. Oh, that's gonna go off. Oh man. I can't AWS is gonna go off in the other cab and I can't hold on. Gonna have to go over there and turn that off. Yep, it's going off here. Alright, let's get that turned off. That and that and reset. Okay. I think that was it. Should be good now. I didn't think that would go off since the engine was turned off, but I guess it does. Museum. Watch it, boat museum. Cool. This is the Watch It station. What's going on here? Why are we slowing down? The throttle set to full. What's going on? Brake's not fully charged or something. Alright, we'll do this really quick. Full service. Go ahead and release the brakes now again. Alright, give it some gas to go forward. We are going backwards. Nope. Forward. Get some power. There we go. A little bit. Still, something's not right. Because I have the brakes on the other cab. Is that why? Something here is not right. Also, I changed these settings. Maybe I gotta change these back. If I remember what they were, set two. Back and brake, passenger, goods, air brake. We don't want the air brake. So I think it was that was set to passenger, and this was set to closed. Are we moving? Oh shit, we're moving. Oh shit. Oh shit. Stop. Stop the train. Stop the train. Oh, this end's not stopping. Oh no. Emergency. Emergency. Stop. Stop. Thank you. This, put that back into neutral, shut down. Hopefully that won't move. Alright, I think that was it. Isolated. Yes. Okay. I think we're good now. Close the door. There we go. Try this again. Still moving at a very slow pace. I don't know what's going on here. Something is not right. There we go. I had to get the I guess the gear throttle gearbox out of whatever state it was in there. Now we should be moving. There we go. Hello, Grape. How's it going? Welcome in. Doing good, just woke up about an hour ago. Nice. I'm doing all right, thank you. I also woke up about an hour ago. Well, actually, it was 2 hours ago, but close. So I feel you on that. Just taking a nice train ride along the West Somerset Railway. Random question, but what made you into this train game? That's a very good question. I watched a few different YouTubers that played these train games, and I really liked it. I really enjoyed it, and when I found out it was coming to console, I was like, "Oh, I need to get into this because I really enjoyed watching, and I like trains too as well." They are really cool. But yeah, so just watching some YouTubers play it and made me want to play it as well. I just realized we are speeding like a bat out of hell here. Let me slow down a bit. Okay. Never heard of it until I started watching you play, but I know there's tons of simulation games. Yeah, there is tons, and I mean tons of simulator games. Of almost anything you can imagine, there is a simulator game for. Person saying beep up on the loop simulation game AO. I mean, I wouldn't doubt it. There probably is, or there might be one being made. You never know. I would not doubt it. There is a there's a game called Talking Simulator, or Speaking Simulator, whatever it's called. And that is looks like a very interesting game. I wonder what it's about. I bet it's not about speaking. hold on, actually. Let's see here. Share it here in the chat. It's on Steam. There you go. So you can see what that's about. It's very. It's kind of creepy in a way. Yeah, that's what it seems like. You actually use your tongue. Yeah. Your tongue to talk. It looks like it would make for some funny moments, though. Not gonna lie. Do you have a vague understanding of human interaction? Well, this is the game for you. Oh my goodness. What a description. Down to a 5, huh? 5 mile an hour. about to clip through a building here in a moment. Nope, we're on the roof. Thought it was gonna clip through. Yeah, I'm trying to think of the other simulator games that are very odd that are out there. Because there's quite a few. One thing we need in life is houses, but they are trains. Whatever this, that might just be RV. Yeah. Wonder if there's an RV simulator. It'd just be like an RV life simulator. You just live out of an RV. You travel. You travel the world in the RV. That would be an interesting game. Oh god, there is one? RV renovation? Oh my god, there is. Oh wow. See, there's... That's literally a simulation for everything. Almost there. A little bit further. Probably speed up while I still can. I still got 700 yards until the 10-mile-an-hour zone. Now we're in the 10 zone. Alright. Here we go. Ooh. We're good. So I think all we're doing, we're just bringing this train here, stopping it, and I think that's it. I think that's all we're gonna do on this objective. Yeah, to stop at the loop. Low power. Alright. There we go. Alright. Right here would be good. Right here. There we go. Perfect. Have to go get some work to do, but it's nice chatting. Yeah, nice chatting with you, Crip. And hope you have a great rest of your day. Thank you for stopping in. Really appreciate it. And I hope I will see you again soon. Okay, bring this train into service from the yard. We can do that. This one. I think it might be the same though, to be honest. You know, the master key, you gotta put that in first. Now, where's the reverser? There it is. Set that to forward. Any of these work over here? Marker lights. Light switch on. Tail lights. Left hand side, right hand side. I don't know. I don't know which one. Leave those off, I guess. Tail light. Wipers. I do S. Okay. So this driver brake over there, we'll release that. That's built up, and then right, I think it is good. Go ahead and put throttle. I tell this one's diesel. Hear that diesel engine? Those brakes. We're gonna brake it earlier. Alright. Just make sure. Okay, it is. Good to go. Definitely on these older trains, we gotta brake much sooner. you? We got this, we got this. Brakes. Full service. There. That's good. Very good. Let's go ahead and unlock the doors. Right side doors. There we go. Immersion. Alright, that's all we're gonna do is load the passengers. Easy. Should be an easy. Oh, guess it's not a gold. Easy silver, then. We'll take it. So now we can return to free room. Service is scheduled to start at 10:15. Alright, so we got a few minutes here. So we can get out and have a look around the station here. Oh, wait. Let's see what we got. Minehead. What is this? Ah, milk churn. Nice. Reader's halt. Nothing there? Okay. Note here. Nothing. Litter. Thing on the side. It's about the same. Alright. Bristol. Western. It's very blurry. Kind of hard to read. Hmm. What's that? Minehead Shunter Scenario Part 1. No thanks. Ladies' room, information office. It's down over here. Buy a bucket to a 15. Hey, ice cream over there. Let's grab some ice cream. Ah, I can't. Can't go over there. I want some ice cream though over there. I want ice cream. They did a nice job with the train station, though, making it as detailed as possible. Between the hanging plants and all the signs. Got picnic tables over here. Turntable cafe. Oh, we even got the turntable right there. Very cool. Here's the old carriage again. Very nice. This way, really. Anything else? I think those are their only things. Climb this? No. Okay. Oh, hold on. Fire bucket right here. Yeah. 3 of 15. Now I think that's it. Step up here. Get ready to go here in a moment. Back inside. Alright. It's all good. Let's put that on. On the AWS cab chains over. Leave that on. Vacuum pass. Okay. So just got a minute left. And we can roll out. So it looks like we're going to have a few stops to go do. Our first stop will be Dunster Platform at 10:22. And then wherever we go from there. Doors. Release the brake. Away we go. To Dunster. Hello, Henry. How's it going? Hello, Angelos. How's it going? Welcome in, welcome in. I can try. What would you like to know? Think about getting it for my birthday, but not sure if it's worth it. Well, in my opinion, I would say, if you're really into trains and you like having a variety of different trains, I would say it's worth it. Because there's a nice variety here. Although, if you do buy the, what is it? There's two different versions. There's like the Rush Hour version, and then there's the, I think it's just the base version. The base version just has three routes. It has Sand Patch Grade, which is the freight operation. They got high speed routes. It's in Germany. There's also the London Underground, the tube line. That's kind of what you get with the base. Is there only three types of locomotives? There's a little bit more locomotives. But yeah, in the base, if you get just the base game, yeah, there is the three locomotives. Actually, there's like two or three extras put in there that are part of the base game. I'm totally gonna go past this stop. Just realized. Oh shoot. Oh boy. It's okay. It's fine. There. Yeah, the London Underground only has one train. The German routes, the Colin, however you say it, has two trains though. Has two trains. The high speed train, and then it has the commuter style type train, the S-Bahn. And then obviously the Sand Patch Grade has the freight trains. You actually get three in those. So you actually get more than the three trains. So you do get a decent amount of trains to start off with. You might only get three routes, but you do get a decent amount of trains. Think of getting the Collector's Edition. That's a good one too. Collector's Edition, you get the it's the East Coast Way. Plus, I thought there was another route that you got as well. I think it was. I can't remember what it was. I know one of them is East Coast Way. There any steam locomotives? There is not yet. There is no steam locomotives just yet, but they are working on designing them. So they will be coming. Just we don't know when. It's still new to them. Right now, it's just the diesel, the electric trains. And that's about it at the moment. You make your own route. There is a scenario editor. You can kind of make your own stops. Yeah, so there's kind of some similar to that, where you can along the three routes. I personally have not touched that though. I haven't really checked it out, to be honest. But there is a scenario planner. I'm actually gonna, and I'm just not feeling that right now at the moment, but I can show you that really, really quick and show you kind of like what you get. So I have the base game, plus I have a bunch of the DLCs. But with the base game or the collector's edition that you'll get, it's gonna have Sand Patch Grade here. It'll have this route and this one. And whatever the collector's edition has, I don't know if it's this or East Coast Way. So you can't make your own tracks or trucks. You can design your own train liveries. You can do that, but no, you can't like create your own like track designs. You can't do that, unfortunately. You just have the set routes, but you can adjust them the times. Which, let me go in here and I can show you. So you have this thing called, so you have your tools down here. You have the livery designer, which can design your train liveries, and here's the scenario planner, which here you can add, we'll just call this test. And from here, just go ahead and add whichever station you want to start off at. So let's just say we'll start off at platform 2 here. So this would be your starting point. Just got to confirm it. And then where you would like to end at. This is the farthest you can go, is 427 miles, I think. I think that's what that is. But you can end there, and then you can select what routes, what stops you would like along your route. So you don't have to do all the stops, you can just do one or two or whatever. So three locos are more for the collector's one. Yeah. So it's like a few extra ones, I believe. Yeah, so that's that, but I will show you. So yeah, you get the Sand Patch Grade, you get this. But when you go to click on like Sand Patch Grade, go to explore here, go down to timetables, and see, we got three trains right here for this route. Three different trains that you can use. That's for Sand Patch Grade. For this one, we have not all those, unfortunately, not all those. You just have this one, the BR 406, and then you have the Talent 2. Those are the only two that you will start off with. The rest of these here are all like DLC ones that I have purchased, so those you would have to buy. And then you have the London Underground Bakerloo line, and that I believe is only one train. Yeah, the tube stock train. That's all you get up for this route. But like I said, unfortunately I don't have the collector's edition. I can't tell you the rest of it, what you get, but that's just some of it. So hopefully that helps you out a little bit. And then with the livery designer, you know you can sign your own trains, like I said. Don't know what this. Is your version on PS4? Yes, this is PS4 version, correct. Yeah, so this is that high-speed train that you can design the livery for. So you got your paints here. You can change whatever color you want. You got you can add layers of different shapes, designs, text, signs, images. So you get like some custom images here. Different signs you can put on. And is it expensive? It is, I believe it was $50, but depending on where you are, where you live. I know in the States it's like $50, I believe. 50 plus change. But I think the collector's edition was like 55 or something. The regular edition, I think, is 50. So it was almost like 60, I would say. But like I said, you have to look in your either PlayStation store, or if you're getting it on disc, you'd have to see how much it is. So I'm not really sure. I live in Greece, so we use euros. Gotcha. So, I'm not sure what it is for you. Unfortunately, you'd have to look it up. But it should be there in your PlayStation store. But this game is—it's a very good game. You know, it's a very good train representation. I mean, yes, it has its bugs, and but it's nothing really game-breaking. At least not at the moment. It was before. There was some issues with some stuff, but. They're working on it, and right now it seems to be fine, so isn't really anything that game breaking. Collector's edition for us is 40 to 50 euros. I see. So yeah, it's up to you, you know, if you wanna buy the game or wait for a sale, it's up to you. So your version is going to be cheaper than that. Like I said, I start off with the normal version, the regular base game. So that was a little bit cheaper at the time, but then I went and bought, you know, all these DLCs, so that added up. But yeah, but I would say, yeah, go for the collector's edition. Go for it. You know, it's a good starting pack, having the collector's edition, for sure. Tell me the name of your version. I don't know if it's still. I don't know if it's changed or not from the store, but it was just Train Sim World 2 when I first bought it. But now it might be Train Sim World 2 Rush Hour now, I think what it's called. I think that's like the base game now. That's the new name for it now, I believe. So you bought the other trains. Yeah, so I bought Peninsula Corridor was the one I bought. I believe these two were from the first Train Sim World game. So this kind of carried over. There's a thing called Preserved Collection, and if you owned DLC from the first Train Sim World game, it would carry over to the second game. So some of these are from the first Train Sim World game. But yeah, these are all the DLCs that I own. Yeah, that's all I got. And how are you not getting bored of doing the same routes? Well, see, the thing is, I don't play this game all the time, so I kind of just play it in different. I don't know how to describe it. Different times, I guess. So that's why I don't get bored of the game. I just don't play it constantly. Don't. I just do like a few routes at a time. So I feel like if you're just like doing one route for like a long time, you get bored with it. Or if you're just doing all these different routes and like within the first few days or so, yeah, you definitely get bored. But that's why I try to mix it up and not play this game all the time. That way I can kind of stay into it. That's what I found. Because I totally understand how it would get boring if you're, yeah, just playing this constantly in the same routes. Especially if you don't own all the DLCs and you're just kind of stuck with the ones that you start off with. And there's a lot of different routes. With the ones you start with. A lot of different routes. Different timetables, different things. Okay, I think I might not get it because I think I'm gonna get bored and it's not very cheap. Yeah, I would probably wait for a sale then. That would probably be your best bet. And you know they always put this game on sale along with the routes, so just keep an eye out because I'm sure it'll be on sale again. What content do you usually upload? I'm kind of all over the place at the moment, but I do upload quite a bit of simulation games that are on PlayStation. You know, from here, Train Sim World, to Mud Runner, Snow Runner. What else? Oh, Bus Simulator as well, On the Road. And I also do a few open world games time to time. Like currently I've been playing Days Gone and doing that on stream. And as well as GTA 5, the story mode, not online. But yeah, that's what I usually upload on this channel for live streams at the moment. I'm probably gonna do one more of these. Which Beast Wars train simulation game is the best in your opinion? Well, there's only one. It's Train Sim World. That's the only train simulation game on PS4 at the moment. So, hello, Welsh Monkey, welcome in. Yeah, Train Sim World is the only train simulation game on PS4. I know Xbox has, I think has a few on Xbox, I believe, a few different ones, but I'm not entirely sure. My day is going well, Welsh. How is your day going? Get this thing started. Right, Angels, no problem. Thank you for stopping in and hanging out for a little bit. Hope you have a great rest of your evening. Hope to see you again. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Welsh. Very sorry to hear that. Seems everybody's still getting that. There. Gonna go change the track down there. Probably could have just drove up there, to be honest, but we're gonna run over there. So let's change. There we go, to the right. Release the automatic brakes. Have I played this lots of times? Yes. But I do not play it, all the time. But I have played quite a bit of this game. Wipers on here. There they are. Eh, I don't think we need on fast. We'll just put it on into there. That'll work. It was just snowing. Now it's not as much. It's a little bit. I may have to turn the desk console light on here when we stop up here, so I can see. PlayStation or Xbox, do you like more? Well, I have not played the new Xbox, so I couldn't tell you about that. I've only played PlayStation, so. I would say I love PlayStation. All that easy, I like more PlayStation. I feel like both platforms have, you know, their strong points and their bad. They got their good and their bad. Oh, too much break. Now we got our train formed, we can head to Southampton Street Yard. After we stop up ahead. Probably turn that bell off now. There we go. Perfect. So now I think we are. Let's switch tracks here again. Yeah. So now we can move this one to the left. This one, I think it's fine where it's at. Yeah. There we go. There. Oh, I can't move the camera any further back. This bridge, I guess, is in the way. And go over the bridge? No, can't even do that. Okay. Okay. Does not like that bridge, apparently. There we go. You're ready to stop up here. That's a good shot. All right, I guess we'll continue on. The formation, three vehicles. All right. Going a bit fast. There we go. Perfect. Hold on 1 second. Sorry about that. And wow, we just passed a red signal. Didn't think we were that close to a red signal, but I guess we were. Oof. I should have paid more attention to that. And I did not mid-save that. Oh, that sucks. That sucks. Well, I guess on that note, I'm going to end this stream. Yeah. We've been going for a few hours now. Just wanted to do a little short stream here today. We'll be back next week. Because I don't think we're doing a stream tomorrow night. I'm not sure, though. Maybe we might. I don't know. If not, I'll see you guys next week. Thank you for watching, and hope you all have a great rest of your evening, or whatever time it is for you guys. So, yeah, see you guys next time. Bye.